music is a lot of people's first love. I was always quite fascinated by drums.
Church music is like, the organ and the piano is like a very fundamental thing, but the drums is like the pulse.
A lot of people come to church just to listen to the drums.
So when I started playing the drums in church, I would have been about four or five years old. The first context I heard live music was to help people worship. A lot of those services are long, and if you start making songs drag, it's gonna make what was already a long enough service drag even more, do you know what I'm saying? So you gotta make it feel like it's bouncing, it's pushing, it's pushing. One of the first things that you'd get deep into is people would use reference to your pocket, and it's kind of like how you feel each speed. A good drummer needs to be able to identify which version you're gonna play and be able to keep locked into that. For me, there's three gears, if you like. There's behind the beat, there's on the beat, and there's in front of the beat. If we're at 120 BPM, can you make that 120 feel slow? Can you make that 110 feel bang on? Can you make that 120 feel fast? Maybe apart from the bass, none of the other instruments can really do that as effectively as the drums.
It was in Lagos. My uncle has a church. He was a pastor at his church. And that was my first experience kind of being in a setting where there's live instruments, there's a whole atmosphere that comes with it. And I felt like, oh my God, this is what a drum kit does. Music in itself is something that is a purest form of just connecting to each other and to God. It's just beautiful to see how cultures put their own spin on it.
The West African kind of 6-8, 12-8 Nigerian rhythm that you play in a lot of those types of songs, that's like one of the core drum beats. It would be one of the first ones I've learned.
After church, when we were kids, we would try and get on, like, sneak onto the drums. Going to a Caribbean church, you hear a lot of soul card, a lot of calypso. The black church does create like that early music environment for you. For me, I wouldn't know about stems. I wouldn't know about the click track, which you need to keep your time in.
The UK, we have a rich scene in gospel music. I started playing drums when I was like 2. And then church was like 5. So like Pentecostal, my background, you got gospel chops. You've got licks. You're still keeping the beat. People think that it's just American. Now, the UK, we can do our thing as well. Musicians will stay around something called shedding. It's just literally showing off. It's not required, but we do it. So sometimes you have 4, 3, everyone sets up a kit and literally just going for it, expressing ideas, expressing improvisation feels.
A lot of these churches, the drum kits just aren't amazingly great condition, and they're not that great a lot of the times. A lot of the times they're a little bit beaten up. One drum will be slightly broken, which I think is a beautiful opportunity to work out how you're gonna make this drum kit sound good.
People just getting together, making what they can of what they have.
I say to anyone, the highest level of musicians anywhere in the world is gospel musicians. I tell you, it's a fact. Most of the pop singers that you see, it will be gospel musicians backing them.
My younger brother, TJ, he's the bass player in Ezra Collective. And then Toby, he's the guitarist in a band called Kokoroko. We all grew up together. We were the church band. I don't want to be the main focus when Ezra Collective are playing. I want it to be something a lot bigger than just the 5 of us on the stage. And I think church really gave me that way of approaching music and stuff. A lot of people even say after Ezra shows, they say they feel like they've been to church or something, because we're out here screaming and preaching and then telling everyone to shout and scream and drum.
To grow up and watch things like jungle transform into grime, transform into garage, and then you have other things that have come up along the same way, like even a jazz scene that's going on in London right now. It makes me so proud to know like how far we've come, and we have that for ourselves that we can call our own.
Through being black in the UK, you're going to experience a lot of things, good and bad. And I feel like all around the world, as black people, we've always found a way to communicate if you're angry or upset or happy through music.
Whether it's secular, gospel, I feel like music as a whole is the closest you get to God.
We all resonate very naturally to the sound of percussion. When it comes into like the church context, it's a very natural thing people kind of look towards. They stamp and they clap. I think it aids people feeling together. It aids that feeling of community. Black churches specifically have provided this for people. The instruments you hear in a black church are very likely going to be similar to the instruments you'd hear if you watched Glastonbury on TV. Music is just such a freeing way for everyone to identify to something.
Leading back to gospel music and gospel drumming, it's like, it makes you want to dance. It makes you want to feel.
I feel like music, no matter what, is an unspoken language that we all have in us and we all understand.
Playing now, it's becoming a second nature. I still need to learn a few things. I just play what I can play and I try and play for God.
Hey, where we,